said Moseby, the most legendary bounty hunter in all of Los Angeles. He's my boss, my mentor, the father I never had.
Ed, what did you do before you were a bounty hunter?
I played music. I was a musician.
Really?
Yeah.
What, in a band?
Did you ever hear of Stevie Ray Vaughan?
But you're shitting me.
Stevie and I hooked up in Austin. Back in the day, we did the bus tour thing together. Let every goddamn small club that would have us. Yeah. Yeah, me and that boy, we tore it up.
Holy shit.
Yeah, we played some with Pat Benatar, but that was only when I needed cash.
Oh, fuck off. I love Pat Benatar.
So did I. That's another story. Love is a battlefield, baby.
In 2003, I was named Bounty Hunter of the Year.
Domino, you cover the side. Choco, you cover the rear.
Steve McQueen was in, but it's always just somebody who operates just inside or outside of the law, or quite a romantic figure, you know. He wanted a relationship piece between Choco and Domino and Ed. I think it worked really well that he cast Édgar Ramírez, because, you know, Édgar was very gung-ho. Aside from all the action stuff, he's really great to work with when you got to do the, you know, the acting stuff.
Domino Harvey. You're probably wondering how a girl like me arrived here. I am a bounty hunter. My name is Domino.
What I say will determine whether or not I spend the rest of my life in prison. Let's start at the beginning.
Have you had a nose job?
No.
Okay, Domino, you're with me on the side. Choco, you cover the rear.
Looks like Night of the Living Dead.
Absolutely brilliant.
As a black Tino woman, I believe we deserve our own race category.
Did you just say black Tino?
Now that must have more kids than my event Holyfield.
There's only one conclusion to every story.
My name is Domino Harvey.
We all fall down.
My name is Domino Harvey. I am a bounty hunter. Heads you live, tails you die.
You get one cheap. I mean, hey, just get one that's
good. My relationship with Samuel is really close because his father was my dear best friend. And I have a responsibility to his father and to him to look out for his well-being and his best interests. And so when he gets his head, you know, underwater a little bit, I want to be there for him. Tony and I sort of went through it together because I couldn't get like a direct read on it because it's, you can't really read it off the page, so you can more or less try to turn this character into something that's not so obvious, because you're dealing in the world of kidnapping here. And my character is sort of conducting this whole little thing, and there's a lot of evasiveness. There's a lot of evasiveness with the answers that I give or the questions that I ask.
Action, guys!
As bodyguard, if you take a bullet for your employer or somebody.
Well, I'm not being paid to protect Mr. Ramos, so.
That's a good answer.
And then you got the history of the piece where Mark Anthony's character and his father and I were very tight. And he's sort of like a loose cannon. He's got this great looking wife that he's got to keep happy.
For an American, she sure knows how this country works.
She knows men. She knows you, my little pendejo, my little pubic hair. You better get strong, Samuel, or that pussy's gonna walk all over you.
Too late.
Tony was giving me his cigars to smoke at the table, and they got me high. So that we started laughing while we were talking it, and Tony said, keep doing it that way.
Guys, you got one more in you. Excellent, great, excellent. Mickey, Mark, excellent, guys, really good. Keep good, guys, really good.
And the more cigars they kept giving me, the more I couldn't say a line without laughing, and then he started laughing, and I don't know if Tony will use any of that, but we certainly had a good day.
For an American, she sure knows how this country works.
Excuse me?
I'm just suggesting ways that he can keep his life together, keep his wife, and have some money, whether it be, you know, a good way to get it or a bad way to get it. Right now, it's the only way to get it.
Action, Javier.
Blessings.
It's like a no-win situation, you know? It's like, you know, when you do something and you know, fuck, I'm gonna get caught, I'm gonna get burned, you know? It's like, you sense that shit's gonna go down, you know? So it's, you read this material and you don't know what's gonna happen on the next page. And then you get Tony in there, who every day comes up with a new idea. Like, today's scene would be good, it'd be all right, but the fact that he's doing it on the patio and the veranda with the rain, it helps the ambiance, the whole piece. There's like a heaviness to the piece. You feel like you're sinking.
She's my little girl, Jordan.
Everything's gonna be all right.
I eat 3 cakes, chocolate cakes.
See? This is it. Crazy. So this is Mr. and Mrs. Kalfus.
You're the bodyguard. You're the one that was in special ops.
What?
So what do you see out there? See the danger? The fear is always worse than the goddamn reality, huh? Listen, let me ask you a question. It's
It's nothing personal. It's a professional curiosity. As a bodyguard, you take a hit to save your employer for some win?
I'm not being paid to protect Mr. Ramos.
That's a good answer. How about the kid? What about her?
Well, a minimum close protection team consists of four men. Even in a low-threat situation, you got at least two. Security-trained driver and operator. In this case, you just got me. So if something were to happen to her, I would do my best to protect her at all times. Needless to say that she'd be better off if I didn't get shot.
Man, that's technical, but what kind of answer is that?
The answer's the truth. The question's frivolous.
All right, so we're going to go.
Okay.
Nice to see
all
you.
Right.
Okay. All right? Come on. Jump. All right?
Yes.
There were 24 kidnappings in Mexico City in the last 6 days. Have you protected a lot of children before, Mr. Creasy?
I don't know. Bodyguard's gotta be close to people. You know, I'm no good at that.
You're the silent type. People are gonna appreciate that.
16 years of military experience, extensive counter-terrorism work.
What happened to your hand?
It's a birth defect.
No, it's not.
No more questions. That's it. Period. You hear me?
Peter just wants to be friends.
I regret that your profession needs to exist.
So do I, Marjorie.
He's like a bear.
Yeah?
Big, sad bear. Good things happen too, Creasy.
Yeah? Like what?
Like meeting me. Creasy, you're smiling.
Peter! Peter!
Creasy's art is dead. He's about to paint his masterpiece.